can imagine is impossible.
And so, when did the Lord touch you when you came now to Kaptembwa for a meeting?
Power. Nini kapiga magoti pale, nikaongea na Mungu, nikasema Mungu nione. Na wakati nilikuwa pale ukasema, wewe usipopata uponyaji wako hapo, utapata kwa barabara ukirudi.
So how did you know you are healed? Ulijuaje umeponywa? How did you know you are healed?
Nyumbani, nikiwa na hiyo imani, utapata uponyaji wako kwa barabara. Na mimi nikufika nyumbani, nilikaa wiki tatu. Nikingoja uponyaji. Paka hata karibu ni loose of tenant.
Okay, I heard that is what I was waiting for. So I heard that you felt the metals became heavier
on
the
drill.
He says the only way he knew that he's healed is when he felt the weight of the metals, pain. He felt now there is so much pain. I must have been healed. I need to remove them.
So nikatoa hapo nyumbani.
Yes, I am told you drill, you unscrewed them yourself. Can you tell these people?
So nilipungua na spana number 10. 10, 11. Nikapungua. Na wakati nilikuwa na pungua, nilikuwa na sweat, nilikuwa na tetemeka, nilikuwa na sikia uchungu sana. Nilikuwa, hata nilikuwa na lia kama mtoto.
How do you unscrew this? How do you unveil this yourself at home? And then, now finish with me here quickly. You unveil and then you call your doctor. I am told. Can you give this for the full story?
So nilimpigia daktari kabla hata sijapungua.
Akaniambia
uwe familia mpaka kesho ukuje. Na mimi sikuweza kufumilia sababu nilikuwa natetemeka, nilikuwa na sweat, sasa nilikuwa nasikia uchungu sana. Na kushika nikasikia sasa kama inatengeseka yote. Nikasema hii ndio uponyaji. Nikapata nyumbani, nikafungua. Wakati nilifungua, daktari nikampigia daktari. Daktari, chuma nimetoa. Akaniambia, "Ati nini? Umetoa chuma?
Ati nini?
Umetoaje?" Hakuamini. Hallelujah.
I like that.
Napenda hiyo.
Ati nini? That's what I was told.
When he
called the doctor and said, "Anyhow, I have removed it." The doctor said, "Ati nini?" Yeah, then the doctor said, "You are going to die. Run to hospital."
Akaniambia kuja na hicho chuma haraka sana. Mimi sikwenda. Nikakaa mpaka kesho nyingine baada ya siku mbili.
Unakula tu pale unalala tu pale.
Unakula na unalala vizuri.
Ninakula na ninalala vizuri.
I was eating and sleeping well.
All these are deaf.
Our water is
we are coming.
Tunakuja.
Plus many deaf here.
Na pamoja na vizuri wengi wengineo hapa.
Today I don't know whether the Lord has healed 30 or more deaf here.
Leo sijui kama Bwana ameponya 30 ama zaidi vizuri hapa.
But let us finish because of time.
Lakini wacha tumalize kwa sababu ya wakati.
So you unakula na unalala pale.
Vizuri.
You are eating and sleeping there.
Mama alikuwa amesema sasa uanze mwita. Sasa hata ujenda hospitali. Mimi nikaleti wilisari baada ya tukulini. Kupika huko nitakuta daktari ananingoja. Akio na wasungu. Ananingoja. Sasa wakaniambia. Sasa ni nini ilifunga ile mashimo. Wakanipeleka MRI. Picha ya kompyuta. Wakaona kweli kuna mashimo. Lakini ni nini imefunika. Hewa hii kuingia ndani.
Oh yes.
Wakamulika mwa ndani.
Because I am told if some air had entered the brain, he would have died.
Kwa sababu nilikuwa nikipata kinungi na nyagoko
Except Jesus. Because he can do such mighty works. He qualifies. He is worthy of being worshipped alone. We cannot mix him. Other gods have no power. They cannot do these things. And so that's why we don't have time. I just wanted to. It's done.
Imekwisha.
Ana kuongoja pale na wadaktari wazungu. Ana kule uko wapi? Umeingia wapi? Naingia kinunge. Umefika wapi?
Ndio mpaka wakati
nilishuka. They are following every 5 minutes.
Wanakuatilia baada ya dakika 5.
Sasa wakati nilishuka pale nikawaambia nimeshuka kwa hiyo aiyo. Kwanza nikapata na ikiwa na hizo chuma kwa baba.
Ninawarudishia. I sent the archbishop.
Nilimtuma askofu mkuu.
Last week I sent the archbishop. I said, go back there to the hospital. And ask them to give you those
tumors.
So we can use it as evidence and build a case against the enemy. Thank you. Can we move on because of time? Thank you so much. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So now, the death, can you come? All those the ear open, come out. We have the television cameras on this side. So now, there are so many deaf ears that have opened. Alex, this is a flood. Inundation. This is a big flood of miracles. Unbelievable. No, but for her, she's even blind. These are blind eyes that open.
Where will you go? Yes.
Nini? Kidogo. Kama unaona kidogo, tafadhali chukua. Chukua.
Take it.
Nataka kuambia tuko kwa TV, nataka watu wa TV waone. Unaona chukua. Ukiniona nifuate. Unaona?
If you see the prophet, then you can follow him.
Unaniona? Niguze, niko wapi? Nataka waone, waone ukiniguza. The blind eyes. You know, she's learning to live with sight. She's beginning baby steps. So even the walking is a blind person's walking. The miracles of Jesus are sweet miracles. Just give me 2 minutes. Yes, man, Jimmy's back from a catechism. take it. Can you follow me? Everybody now, focus on me here. Whoever is doing lead, remove your lead. And this blinder is open. Okay, thank you. Can you just move closer inside? Yes, continue to handle the situation there, please. Just handle the situation there. And I'll praise Him forever and ever for the cross. Let's go here now. And I'll praise Him. The cross day. Worship Him, that is powerful. Repeat it again. And I'll praise Him. Sikoke watu, tafadhali kwa jina la Yesu. Simama kabisa wachana na mambo. Tafadhali usikonge watu, tafadhali kwa jina la Yesu. Usikonge watu. One more time. Can I start it here again? Listen, everybody, now. I want to announce here that I don't know about you, but for me, I know that the old rugged cross made a whole lot of a difference. It changed my life. It made me know that the Lord is here.
You call Papa.
It made me know that eternity belongs to Him.
Ni wake.
So we need to continue. You may go through life and you think you are in charge. But today I speak to Kenya. That there is one who is in charge. Heaven has its owner. The gospel has its owner. Salvation has its owner. And nobody has a right to destroy this glorious salvation of the Messiah. Because deaf ears have opened blind ears. Blind eyes have opened ears. Broken hips. Babies that were lying, they were crippled. Now they have hope to face life with courage, to walk again on their two feet. Why? Because of that old, dirty, rugged cross. La cruz sucia in Spanish. Dirty.
Muchapo.
In a life full of heartaches and mistakes, how crazy those. I need to go to those healed. We don't have time. We don't have time. Please, we don't have time. I know there are so many people healed here. We need to come. Don't forget that cross. Don't forget it. You cannot forget it. It's too strong. Look the strength of the cross. How many are there? There are 25 deaf ears have opened. Okay, now can you shut down everything so we find out what's going on here? The Lord has healed his people. Free of charge. Is this boy one of them? Silence, precious people. We don't have time on air now. kusherekea uponyaji wako na wimbo huu. Wimbo na mziki. Nyumbani mwako. So much. If you are here, you just say it. We don't have time to read it. Mama, Pastor, wait, Mama, we can get a Mama, Pastor. Pastor, I'm a Mama, Pastor. Okay, thank you so much. You'll be a good one, Mr. Pastor. Thank you. That's where the altar is. Very good, thank you. At the gate, they recorded this person totally blind. Thank you. And now, look at what the Lord has done. Thank you, my son. Thank you. Thank you for allowing the Lord to use you. You can see I'm in a hurry here. The Lord helps me. So, sir, we need a chair. Nataka upite kati ya watu utafute chair na kiti na watu. Kama unaona kiti pale kwenda kiti ndio sasa. Oh, you can come this side. What are you talking about? Yeah, but can you see a chair in front of you? Live on TV.
Moja kwa moja katika runinga.
Okay, can you be quiet for a moment because of time? Can you give me a soda so I can help my son with the camera here? Because he has not drunk since he came. Thank you. No, now I don't understand this. I was saying the deaf prepare. Because we don't have air time. We have only 5 minutes. And then, this lady gets out of the line of the deaf and sits there. Then I told her, don't do that. Why are you leaving the line? She says, no. For me, I was blind and now I can see. We don't want anybody to describe you. Tell us. Na kwa geti ulirekodiwa.
Langoni ulirekodiwa.
Sikulirekodiwa lakini niliwaambia nione hasa mmoja akanileta.
No, tuliweka makamera pale ya kutukuza Bwana. Ungependa kuona wewe ni kipofu, alafu baada ya kuponywa tujue Bwana ataenda kazi gani. this one cannot be recorded. Kipofu wakati huo. Bado kipofu.
Lakini leo asubuhi nilipoamka nikasikia bibi anatoka kwa macho. Nikajaribu kujipanga na hivi nikapata nimeona.
But today in the morning I had like pins were piercing in my eyes.
I felt like some pins were piercing my eyes.
Nikahisi kama vitu vinadunga macho yangu.
Then I was shocked. I could see.
Alafu nikashtuka ninaweza kuona.
So that is it. There's no greater.
Hakuna kubwa zaidi.
I don't have to convince anybody to walk in holiness anymore.
Sistahili kumshawishi mtu yeyote kutembea katika utakatifu sasa.
And fasting.
Na kufunga.
Let us fast and kill out the flesh.
Hebu tukafunge na tukauwe mwili.
That the church may go back to righteousness.
Ya kwamba kanisa lipate kurudia uhaki.
Yes, so now listen to me.
Kwa hivyo sasa nisikilize.
Sasa wewe kipofu ambao macho yamefunguka sasa.
Now you were blind that the Lord has opened the eyes now.
Okay, we don't have time really. Can you just follow me? Another blind.
Yes, my Lord. Totally blind for 38 years.
Totally blind for 38 years. From Kapchorwa, Uganda. So tell me, are you going to switch us off air or what? Look at this now. Hallelujah. Now, it's incredible here. Another blind eye. Blind eyes open. 38 years.
Yes.
Totally blind for 38 years from Kapchorwa in Uganda.
Wow.
Power. The Lord is here. So, and you know, in the dreams I see them a lot.
Na unajua katika ndoto na waona wengi.
But to encounter them is totally different.
Lakini kukutana na wao ni kitu tofauti pia.
Nani alikuleta?
Who brought you here?
Nani alikuleta hapa? Pastor? Uganda. Bishop wa Uganda yuko hapa. Sasa bila kupoteza wakati unaweza kuniona?
Can you see me please?
Mimi nauliza wachana na pastor na bishop. Macho yako yalikuwa namna gani?
How were your eyes?
Wakati ulikuja.
When you came, how were your eyes?
Thank you very much. Duga gani? Unisaidie kidogo. Tafadhali unisaidie kidogo.
Help me, please.
Please just help me. Allow me to walk. Step down so we have the other translator. Thank you. So listen to me. Unisikize vyema. Unaweza kuona na macho. 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 How do you call it in Kisebei? Go.
Konya.
Kope. Unaonge Kisebei. Kuja hapa. The Lord has helped us to the translator. Thank you. Unaonge Kisebei. Mwambie muulize alikuwa kipofu miaka ngapi. So since 1976 you were blind. Ask her, did your eyes open here? Because we don't have time. Ni sawa tu wewe ongea kwa microphone watu wanisikize vyema. Anasema jicho moja ndio limefunguka. Ni jicho gani? Muulize.
Jicho gani? Kwa ngano ni nyenga hata gani? Kwa mtani wewe utani.
Okay, mwambie anaweza kuniona.
Jika tunapii. Jika kwa
So, akiniona nime ba nini? Color gani? I don't know whether they know colors. Since 1976, she may have forgotten colors, right? Okay, ukiniona chukua hii, chukua, mwambie achukue, okay, kwa microphone, chukua. Chukua. This is a very powerful miracle. Nikwate. This is a powerful miracle.
Huu ni muujiza wa nguvu.
The blind eyes have opened here.
Macho ya kipofu yamefunguka hapa.
When I thought I was dismissing them.
Wakati ambapo nalifikiria nilikuwa nawafutilia mbali.
Because I was fighting airtime on TV.
Kwa sababu nilikuwa napigania kwa sababu ya airtime katika runinga.
And I promised I would not do that. You remember?
Nami niliahidi sitafanya hivyo.
I said I will go slow.
Nikasema nilisema nitaenda polepole.
Regardless of whether we are on air or not, but now I was rushing.
Bila kuzingatia tuko hewani ama la, lakini sasa nilikuwa nakimbia.
And then,
alafu,
two people that were totally blind.
Watu wawili waliokuwa vipofu kabisa.
The eyes have opened here.
Macho yamefunguka hapa.
Chukua soda ukunywe.
Chukua soda unywe.
That's amazing.
Hiyo yashangaza.
And you see,
na unaona,
what is astonishing is this.
Kile ambacho kinashtua ni hiki.
She's a mother.
Yeye ni mama.
So you can imagine how difficult life has been.
Unaweza ukafikiria maisha yalikuwa magumu kiasi gani? Unaweza ukawazia kile ambacho Bwana amemtendea mtoto mama, hii ni kubwa.
Sorry? Yeah, you say we have 10 more minutes? If they can give us more, it's better.
If you want to patia zaidi ni bora.
I need the other translator, please. Thank you very much. So now,
kwa hivyo sasa,
this is a big story.
Hii ni hadithi kubwa sana.
I told you.
Naliwaambia.
There is an avalanche of healing.
Ya kwamba kunao mporomoko wa uponyaji.
A tsunami of healing.
Tsunami ya uponyaji.
Each one of them.
Kila moja yao.
Is very historic.
Ni ya kihistoria.
For example, my daughter here.
Kwa mfano binti wangu hapa.
She could not sit.
Hangeweza kuketi.
She could not stand.
Hangeweza kusimama.
She was blind.
Alikuwa amelala tu.
And today she got up.
Na leo akasimama
and walked away.
Na akatembea.
Each one of them on his own merit.
Kila mmoja yao ni nzuri na ina manufaa kivyake.
Stands.
Inajitokeza.
Sit down.
Catch.
Now she can sit on her own.
Sasa aweza keti kivyake.
And this one here.
Na huyu hapa.
I was in a hurry because of airtime on TV.
Nilikuwa na haraka sana kwa sababu ya muda wa kupeperusha kwenye runinga.
And I'll say.
Nami nikasema.
These are 25 deaf people.
Hawa ni viziwi 25.
And one of them leaves the line.
Na mmoja wao anatoka kwenye ile foleni.
And goes and sits there.
Kisha anaenda na keti pale.
And the Lord Jesus told us.
Na Bwana Yesu akatuambia.
Even one sheep.
Hata kondoo moja.
One sheep goes astray.
Ikiwa kondoo moja atapotea.
Leave the 99.
Wachana na wale 99.
And go and pursue the other one.
Enda utafute yule moja.
So I was in that mission.
Basi nikawa kwenye huduma hiyo.
And then I asked her, why are you leaving the line of the deaf?
Kisha nikamuuliza, ni kwa nini unatoka kwenye foleni ya viziwi?
Said no.
Akaniambia pana.
I am not deaf.
Mimi si kiziwi.
Nalikuwa kipofu lakini macho yangu yamefunguka leo hii. How can you run this? How can you run this meeting?
Wawezaje endeleza mkutano huu?
How does somebody run this kind of meeting?
Mtu awezaje kuendeleza mkutano wa aina hii?
Unaona vizuri? With the left. So hai leo. She said, So, she needs to find, tell, talk to me. No. Are you saying blind eyes have opened? Okay, can I? Then that is very powerful. Okay. Let everything take place now.
Huh?
3 minutes. That's okay. We will continue the testimonies of the Lord. Yes. So this is mighty.
Hii ni kuu sana.
Now.
Sasa.
Na wewe pia unanisaidia mtoto saidia mtoto. Na wewe pia acha amekumbuka. The death now.
It's you, it's us, sir.
My Lord.
Bwana wangu.
Thank you. We are coming. We are coming.
You are short-sighted, my Lord.
Thank you. We are coming because we have 1 minute or 2 minutes or just we have to get to the death. Then we are coming there. Okay, Asante San. So now.
Sasa.
The people behind there, you are going to clap.
Watu walioko kule nyuma mtapiga makofi.
Let the general you're behind them, you clap. You will clap with them together. It's not them.
Hawa ni watu waliokuwa vizuri.
Bishop Kosge, I'm watching you. I'm watching you. Kosge, you are closing with me. Someone is from the reception. Very loud, I want to see how they turn. Very, very loud, non-stop. Okay, these people's ears have opened. Let us clap to the Lord.
Watu hawa masikio yao yamefunguka. Wacha tumpigie Bwana makofi.
Let me now deal with it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Go and sit. Take your seats.
Enendeni mukae.
Can you clap to Jesus?
Mwaweza pigia Yesu makofi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is big.
Hii ni kuu.
The
wivu wameona.
And there are two here.
Na wa, ni wawili hapa.
That I want to hand on.
Ambao nataka kukabiliana nao sasa.
The doctors are working.
Madaktari wa...
So. The lady from Sao Paulo can you come here and worship. Emukule was going to be with my daughter from Sao Paulo, Brazil.
Binti wangu toka Sao Paulo, Brazil.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Asante.
Let us clap to the Lord. Thank you very much. The Lord bless you abundantly. Thank you very, very much.
Asante sana sana.
Thank you.
Asante.
Thank you indeed.
Asante kweli.
Take the microphone. Thank you so much. Now there are blind eyes that have opened here.
Sasa kuna macho kipofu ambaye imefunguka hapa.
Yes, so you can rest for tomorrow. For tomorrow, yes. Thank you very much. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now,
sasa
there are blind eyes here.
Kuna macho ya vipofu hapa
that have opened.
Ambaye imefunguka.
What an awesome day.
Ni siku kuu kiasi gani?
Pastor Maluma.
Mchungaji Maluma.
So much.
Niku zaidi.
Pola.
Pola.
So much.
Niku sana.
It's overflowing.
Inatiririka.
Not from abroad, the one I'm looking at.
Wale ambao umetoka ngambo ndivyo naotazama.
It's overflowing.
Inatiririka hapa.
And each one of them is mighty.
Na kila moja yao ni kuu zaidi.
Very mighty.
Ni kuu sana.
Now,
sasa,
talk to me about this man. Is he the owner of this? Thank you.
Samson Mateka. Kutoka Tika. Amekuwa kipofu kwa muda wa miaka 33. Baada ya kuteseka gonjwa la measles, lakini leo aliguswa na Roho Mtakatifu kwa saa moja, na alikuwa akigongwa kichwa sana. Alipoamka toka katika kuguswa kule, aliwezeshwa kuona. Na sasa aweza kuona bila kutumia kipimo hii.
You see his follow.
Unaona anafuatilia. Yatisha.
Gloria a Dios. Gloria a Dios. It is true.
Ni kweli.
This precious man.
Huyu mtu wa thamani.
His eyes are open.
Macho yake yamefunguka.
How can you celebrate this?
Wawezaje sherehekea haya?
Everybody here.
Kila mtu hapa.
The time is coming now.
Wakati wawadia sasa.
When we are going to receive the Lord.
Ambao tunaenda kumpokea Bwana.
Don't worry, not yet.
Usiwe na shaka, bado kidogo.
Unaenda kuchukua hii.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Praise the Lord.
Ninafurahi sio na kifani.
I'm so happy today.
Mimi nafurahia Yesu.
I'm happy because of Christ Jesus.
Mimi nimekuwa kipofu.
I've been blind
for 33 good years.
Kwa miaka 33.
And now I'm healed.
Na leo nimepona.
Nafurahia ukuu wa Yesu.
I'm so happy for the greatness of Jesus.
Kwa sababu amenitembelea.
Because he has visited me.
Kwa sababu ameona nimehangaika.
Because he has seen the way I've been distressed.
Na vile nilikuwa namtarajia siku hii ya leo.
And the way I was expecting him today.
Na sasa nikasema.
And I said,
mimi nitasikiliza sauti ya Yesu.
I will listen to the voice of Jesus.
Na bila shaka akanikujia.
And it is true, indeed he came to me.
Na akaniponya.
And he has healed me.
Ninashukuru sana kwa sababu naweza ona.
I thank him so much because I can now see.
Naweza ona.
I can see.
Nafurahia sana.
I'm so happy.
Amen.
Amen.
Where are you from? Ulitoka wapi?
He's from Thika.
Who brought you here?
Nani aliyekuleta hapa?
Brought you here?
Pastor Felix.
Who is Pastor Felix? Can you run?
Mchungaji Felix.
Can you run, Pastor Felix? Thank you so much. We don't have time. Tell me.
Niambie.
You know this man.
Wamjua mchungaji.
Yes, I know
this man.
33 good years. No. And how did he come to your altar? He has been worshipping in your church.
He has been worshipping in our church.
That's all right. He mentioned your name. That's what I want to know.
Yes. So he was preached by Pastor Jim Rodani.
No, he says you brought him. Excuse me. We are recording here. Thank you very much. Thank you. So where was he healed from?
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. That's what I want. Now, where are you with him?
Yes, I was.
When he was healed?
Yes.
Can you describe to us then? Thank you very much.
Yes, he fell down.
Oh, the Lord touched him.
Yes.
He stayed there for how long?
Yes.
After 33 good years, one good hour. That's very powerful. Now, talk to me about this man. When you brought him, was he recorded at the gate? What will Kenya ever see before the Lord?
Kenya watasema nini mbele za Bwana?
What will Kenya ever say before the Lord?
Je, Kenya watasema nini mbele za Bwana?
If you fail to enter.
Ikiwa mtakosa kuingia.
No, don't push this. What will Kenya ever say before the Lord?
Kenya watasema nini mbele za Bwana?
Many blind have seen.
Vipofu wengi wameona.
You are blind.
Ulikuwa mkipofu.
Vipofu wenu.
Vipofu wenu wameona.
Can you come back here? Vipofu wenu macho yamefunguka.
Vipofu wenu macho yamefunguka.
Bure bila malipo.
Bure bila malipo.
You are blind, have seen free of charge without paying a penny.
Vipofu wenu macho yao yamefunguka bila kulipa hata ndururu.
What will you ever say?
Mutawai kusema nini?
Before the Lord.
Mbele za Bwana.
So now,
kwa hivyo sasa,
you can see.
Unaweza kuona.
With both eyes.
Ninaweza kuona kutumia macho yote mawili.
Is it both eyes that are open or only one?
Ni macho yote mawili yamefunguka ama moja tu?
Sorry.
Both eyes.
Yote mawili.
Unaweza kuniona? Unaniona.
Because when I close this, I can see you. When I close the other one, I can also see you.
I told you.
Niliwaambieni.
We don't need to run with airtime on TV.
Hatuhitaji kuendeshana na airtime ya runinga.
We need just take time and glorify Jesus.
Tunahitaji kuchukua muda na kumtukuza Yesu.
And keep the issues of live broadcast aside.
Na kuweka masuala ya kupeperusha moja kwa moja hewani kando.
Because we are trying to run through this.
Kwa sababu tulikuwa tunajaribu kukimbia kwa hiyo.
How humongous.
Ni kubwa kiasi gani.
How mighty.
Ni kuu kiasi gani.
How shocking. How historic.
Ni ya kushangaza ya kihistoria kiasi gani.
33 years blind.
Miaka 33 wakiwa kipofu.
So, at what exactly? when he rolled and he got up, how did you, what did you know you have seen? Ulijuaje umeona wakati ulikuwa umelala chini ukaamka?
First of all, I had a big faith that I will receive my healing today.
And when it...
Let me describe that. He says
anasema
that
kwamba,
can you follow me if you can see me?
Unaweza nifuata kama unaweza niona?
He is saying
anasema
that the Lord touched him.
Kwamba Bwana alimuguza.
And then he rolled.
Alafu akabingiria.
And I think he was laid for about an hour.
Na nakisia alikuwa ameguzwa yapata saa moja.
And then he is saying that when he got up, when he woke up.
Na anasema alipoamka.
He felt a severe headache.
Akahisi kuumwa na kichwa sugu.
Then after that,
alafu baada ya hapo,
he realized he could see.
Akagundua kwamba anaweza kuona.
I want to continue.
Nataka niendelee
with him. With him.
Pamoja naye.
In Chile.
Kule Chile.
That woman.
Huyo mwanamke.
That had no eye in the summit.
Ambaye hakuwa na jicho. Kwenye lile shimo la jicho.
When the Lord put an eye there.
Wakati Bwana alipoweka jicho pale.
She says.
Alisema.
Na
nilipofungua macho yangu,
I saw people's hair.
Nikaona nywele za watu.
So I want to follow this.
Kwa hivyo nataka nifuatilie hii.
Wakati macho yalipogoka. Wakati macho yalipogoka. How did you know? Nini uliona ya kwanza? Sweat. This is translated. Thank you.
When my eyes opened, the first thing I saw is the place where I was seated. And when I opened my eyes, I saw the people there and they were jumping.
And then I was in a state of shock and I sweated.
Alafu nilikuwa katika hali ya kushtuka na nilikuwa natokwa na jasho.
He's touching the microphone. You can see what he's saying. When the headache left,
because when the head was aching, I closed my eyes. When I opened my eyes, then I realized that I can see. I looked for my wife where she was because we were together. Then I left her.
I did not find her.
I started calling using a phone, asking, where are you?
Where are you? Where are you?
Uko wapi, uko wapi?
I have received a miracle.
Nime upokea muujiza.
He was calling his wife.
And she told me, I'm here near the altar. And I told her, you can turn around, we meet now, I can see.
Thank you.
Asante.
That is mighty.
Hiyo ni kubwa.
And that's why the Lord sent me here.
Na ndio sababu Bwana kanituma hapa.
Wale walikuwa karibu na mimi nikimtafuta, hata walishangaa.
those that were near me when I was looking for my wife, they were amazed. They started to tell me, touch this one, touch this one, touch this one. And I was happy because of the mightiness of the Lord.
Thank you so much.
Asante sana.
Isn't Jesus mighty?
Yes, Yesu ni mkubwa.
Let us clap to Jesus.
Wacha tumpigie Yesu makofi.
He has done a very big fight here today.
Amepigana vita vikubwa sana hapa hivi leo.
This is a mighty battle.
Hivi ni vita vikubwa.
And he has won.
Na ameshinda.
Thank you so much.
Asante sana.
So we need to get him a chair so he can sit.
Tunahitaji kumtafutia kiti ili aketi.
This man was really blind. Surely he was blind. Glory to the Lord. Next. There is another healing here.
Gladys kutoka Peru.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Can you talk to me? Thank you, my daughter. Yes.
Nabiwa Bwana Unigladi Suarez kutoka Peru. Anasema alikuwa amesimama karibu na madhabahu ya Bwana.
Akaanza kuombea wagonjwa.
Okay,
aliingia huko ndani.
Akaanza kutingizika, kutetemeka bila ile ambayo haiwezi na kulia. Na ikapita yapata risali moja. Na baada ya hiyo akaendelea kutazama miujiza. Lakini basi akagundua kwamba anaweza kuona kutoka mbali na hakuhitaji miwani tena.
She could not see more than a meter.
Yo solamente veía una nube a un metro de distancia y eso me causaba problemas porque la gente pensaba que yo he pasado por cerca de ti.
Thank you so much.
Asante sana.
Can you look at that bus? What do you see on that bus? Thank you. That is very far. That is indeed far. What stick is this? Is this for the bandera of Peru, or this is the stick for the blind? Para bandera. Thank you so much. Thank you. Don't worry, in the conference you will be able to bring this. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. The Lord has healed the guests here also. Thank you, Pastora Adriana. Thank you so much. And then are you going to get where to sit? Find them a chair, somebody. ship came with me. Everybody sing to the Lord. One more time, very loud, the public. Hallelujah. Everybody join in. There are people healed here, right? Today, it is non-stop, right? Thank you so much. The Lord bless you, my son, from Amsterdam. Let us clap to the Lord. Thank you so much. I will give the microphone to him. Thank you, Daktari.
Asante, Daktari.
Amen.
aliletwa na mamake na mchungaji. Nilikuwa nimempata akitembea masokoni, akilala kwenye soko, akiwa na fujo mno.
And destructive.
Na akiwa mtu mwenye fujo. Akamualika aje katika mkutano huu siku kabla ya siku ya jana kuitikia kwake kulikuwa kwamba anaweza toka hata hiyo siku aje Eldoret. Hivyo basi alipoulizwa aje kwenye basi akaja akaungana nao kwenye basi, alafu akafika hapa asubuhi ya leo. Wanasoma mstari katika kitabu cha Yohana mahali ambapo viwete angeweza kufikia kwenye mahali ambapo walikuwa wapate uponyaji wao, na usemi wake ulikuwa kwa nini hao watu waweze msaidia huyu kiwete. Ninaenda kumsaidia. Alafu akasikia kama maji yanatoka kwa miguu yake, na akasimama akaanza kutembea, na akaja akamwambia mchungaji yuko vyema.
And then as a psychiatrist you passed him through.
Alafu kama daktari ulimpitisha. Niliulizwa nije nishuhudie, nikazungumza naye, nipatie historia ya matibabu. Na alikuwa amekomesha matibabu wakati fulani uliopita, lakini leo naweza kuongea vyema kabisa.
Thank you so much. That is the professional assessment of the specialist.
Ni ile usemi ya watalu wenye taaluma.
Sasa jina lako ni nani? Songa hivi kidogo pande huu. Pande huu kidogo. Usivike namba. Songa hivi kidogo. Asante sana. Jina lako ni nani?
My name is Roy.
Oh, your name is Roy.
Owuor. Yes, so tell me about this condition.
It disturbed you for some time, right? You got this problem for some time. What was the problem?
I started when I was in school, in high school.
Yeah.
I don't know if I should say the details.
Just give the details.
I was in school.
Yes.
I started one time. I was born again at that time. And then at one time I was annoyed about my results, my doctor results. So at that time I said, let the devil deal with everything. I said that that way. Then I felt a very strange feeling at that time. And then after that, I confessed. And then I got born again. That was before I did my exam and went to university in Nairobi. Then from the new university to Nairobi, I started getting problems. When I was trying to do my exam, I got in a state of pressure. So after that, I got treated with several doctors, about seven different doctors, and people are doing that. And then my parents...
What were you going through? That's what I want to know. What were you passing through?
Psychiatric problem.
Yeah, like what were you doing? You were doing things, right?
Yeah, I would do things. I would, sometimes I'd learn how to exam drugs, how to drink. And then I would go to drinking. I'd get violent at times.
So recently, what have you been involved in recently?
Recently, I've been trying to first of all, I went to get my hearing. I went to the Kakamega meeting. I went to the Kisumu meeting. I went to the Kuru meeting. But apparently, I didn't get anything. So this time, I went to Pastor and she told me, "Why don't you come?" This
is your letter?
Yes, I got it. I got in a state of I used to go, I would get into a boat, you know, just Google type of dead bodies, you know, you would enter.
Yeah,
I would get a morgue and a pathology would tell you, come out. I would go there, although we would take you to a boat, and I would come out, sleep on graveyard. Sleeping just out. I think in the pool, dead
on graveyards.
Graveyards,
so now.
And my grandfather was also with
he was a witch doctor.
Yeah.
So can I ask you a question?
Yes.
When you were abroad here, who brought you again?
Pastor who?
Your name is Joel.
Roy Abou.
So, the pastor, who is your pastor?
James. Okay. Actually, I'm not
Ranala also.
Yeah.
Okay. So tell me, how did you know you've been healed today?
Again, the feeling I had was the feeling I had after reading John. I just believed in my heart that
you read.
I still believe.
Which scripture did you read?
John chapter 5, about the man of the full of God, saying, I was paid for that crazy scandal. And I still believe in my heart that I've gone to several places, but right now I believe in the presence of what I've seen, not from what I've seen, but through faith I've been here.
So, just allow, thank you so much. Thank you so much. So tell me,
yes.
Can you remember things?
Yes, I can recall.
What can you recall?
I can recall being healed again. And that testimony of what you talked about here. You talked about what the church should do, the righteousness in the church. So that you not have.
That's very powerful. And then, I want to take you a little further now. Can you remember what happened yesterday?
Yesterday.
What do you did or anything events?
Some of those things I cannot recall because I'm not in the
you were that's why I want you to pull them back.
I cannot recall, I just lying down.
Where? You remember where you were lying down?
Yeah.
Who were there? So next to the speaker. The pastor, thank you very much. Yes. So next to which speaker? This one or the other?
The other one. Side.
Okay, so thank you. When you were there yesterday, what was happening around you then? Who were there? You really have to remember some people that were singing, worshiping there. Even the clothes and everything they were wearing.
No, I can't recall.
You can't recall. So you received your healing here today?
Yes.
That is amazing. Thank you so much. The Lord is going to restore all your memory. Thank you so much. The Lord has blessed you. Even your doctor here has verified. Thank you so much for taking the Lord. Thank you. Can somebody give him a seat? Come, my daughter. Watch your two mambo high. Sasa. Because the camera, Wango is now confused with camera because we are up there. I don't know whether there's another camera here. We want to make sure we get the front shot. Yes, so, wewe, umesumbuka miaka nyingi sana.
For 17 years.
You can remember the number of years.
Yeah. Even I couldn't see, but when we were praising and worshiping that time, I just feel the feeling that now I can look at the night.
You couldn't see what?
I was using specs.
Oh, yes. That is today here?
Yes. And yesterday, when I was sleeping, light came from, I just had two lights.
Okay, now, what problem have you had? Because what problem have you had?
For mine, beating people. Even
you beat people?
Yes. Even I was just beating anybody when I find anybody. I just beat him. Or if he jumped very bad, I just beat him.
Where did you come from?
From Kakamega.
You beat people in Kakamega?
Yes.
Okay, so that is good that you can remember. Who brought you here?
My mother.
She's around here?
Yes.
And what was your condition? I want you to recall, to pull back, to bring back everything you remember about your condition when you came here. Did you pass through the gate one?
Yes, I passed through gate one.
What did they ask you?
They asked me what was my problem.
And then you told them?
I told them.
What?
I told them that I was sick for 17 good years.
Sick what?
Mind problems.
Mind problems.
Mental sickness.
Did you go to any hospital? Were you hospitalized in a ward?
In Kenyatta, even I went to Madare 2 times.
To Madare?
Yes.
Okay. So now, how did you know that you've been healed? Because I want to investigate you to be sure that the Lord has touched you. I want to go deep with you.
I just felt like falling down, but then I was strong, but I just saw lightning in my mind.
The Lord touched you.
Yes.
And then how did you know you are healed?
I walked from where I was to where my mother was.
Something you could not do before, or what?
Yes. I was just calling her every time, and then every time calling her, even following her.
Are you able to read things now?
Yes, now I can.
Can you read for me what is written from top here?
My name is Irene Dombi, 34 years, resident Kakamega. My contact for mother, 07015-029-37.
Okay. Can you read it better?
07015829 37 has been lunatic for 17 years, has been beating up people, including the mother. She reports her lit by lightning last night. The worship was going on.
Thank you so much. Tell me. God has healed you. What are you going to do now?
With me, I'm just always reading my Bible. Even I've left it down there. I'm always calling my mother with the Bible. Yes, I will serve my Lord Jesus Christ and my Lord living forevermore.
Thank you. This is powerful. I prayed that the Lord heal some mentally ill people here. And you are the answer to that prayer. You don't know how much joy there is in the kingdom of God. 17 years. You were going to toilets also, taking over toilets. What were you doing?
I was just, even I went to form one, I repeated. Form two, I repeated. I finished my form four. And then I went to look for a husband. I got him. He died. I have two children. And now
you went and looked for a husband?
He died.
He died.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Sorry about that. I bless you very much.
So the Lord has now restored your life. Go to church. Be baptized. And don't stop. Follow.
Be baptized in at Kakamega Deliverance Church, Kakamega.
So Bishop Janet is here.
Askofu Janet yuko hapa.
Don't open anywhere, I'm not going anywhere. Many people are healed here. Bring them on, Bishop Little.
Mighty prophet of the Lord. It's a very, very big testimony here.
Can I take one more testimony before this? Let him just come up. Okay. The crippled man on the wheelchair, now is your turn. I need to take the wheelchair of the Lord. If you pass this way, all of you, this way, outside, it will help me. Archbishop, put everything else away from your hands. This man was the watchman. Ukiniona kuja pale niko.
If you can see me come where I am.
This man was healed yesterday. A watchman. And I am told, we are going to hear from him, but I am told that a truck ran over him. Utagonga watu kiniona kuja kwangu. Mimi ndio nakuja kwake. Ukiniona kuja kwangu.
See the prophet of the Lord come to
him. Mama kwanza. Geuka. Geuka tena. Geuka tena. Geuka tena. Unaweza kuniona? Unaweza kuniona? So much. I know a lot of things happened on you, including the healing of your eyes. But I want to begin with your crippledness on this wheelchair. Now, come to me then. If you can see me. Touch me. Then you can see me now. Follow me. Okay, Santa. What is your name? your documents, the newspaper, and the bakuli, the bowl you used to sit with somewhere begging. Where are they? Can somebody bring his things that he was using for begging and the letter from government? Are those the ones? I need them. Thank you very much. Don't block the guests. So, we are relying on you for this front, all right? Yes, you may just do some serious work, whether you want to be there or not. So, now, this was yours. Can you identify this? Maybe you were not able to see it, but do you know what this is? I need a microphone. What is it? Do you recognize that plate? Oh yes, you can feel it, right? So, which means you have been blind also. But I don't want to go into blindness for now. Can we talk about your legs? First of all, your crippledness on this wheelchair? Thank you. The letter from the Government Ministry of Medical Services, UGDH. That's what's English? General Hospital. And it says, on the 22nd day, the month of September, the year 2014, a medical team assembled at UGDH on the 22nd of September 2014 for the purpose of reporting on disability assessment for Oscar M. Wanjala. Is that your name? Your number is 25256192, and your age then was 27 years. Male, sex. Sex, male. And then the members are Dr. John, Eliego, Daniel, Joroy Teach, and the three of them, and Stamp Chitio. They say deformity, right lower limb. Deformity, right lower limb. Visual impairment. Both eyes. Okay, so they've written a bit here. So, what was this document supposed to be used to help you with your ID here? Were they for when the government gave you these documents? It was to certify that you have disability. It's a reappreciation. We are very grateful for your humble service you rendered for this needy person by donating wheelchair to Oscar Mugate. Mugate? Okay. He is so happy for easy movement. So that was you again. Who donated this wheelchair? Parking Limited. Pyramid Parking Limited, right?
Pyramid Parking Limited.
And then I have a newspaper here that covered your story. I wonder which page. It's page what? 15. paralyzed man appeals for help. That's you. Oscar Wanjala, 28, a once strong and determined man from Malava, Western Kenya, recounts in a teary mood how tribulation and misfortune reduced his normal life to a blind crippled beggar in the streets of Eldoret. That's you. Now, when did you come here, my son? To this meeting. Yesterday morning. But what happened to your life that caused you to enter this situation? What were you doing before? Ulikuwa unafanya kazi gani mapema ndio jambo haya yakakutendekea? Macho na mguu. Field officer for which organization? Thank you so much. And what happened to you? Trailer.
Yes, trailer.
You're talking about an 18 wheeler.
Yes, yes. Then it
remove this bond from you with the eye together.
Yes,
no, the eye is inside. So, can you put the microphone? Thank you. It did what? Broke the leg. Well, the leg was what?
Rotting.
So they wanted to put iron.
Yes.
So when those things happened to you, definitely you sought medical treatment, right?
Yes.
Yes. How did you end up in the streets of Eldoret? Just give us a little story. We are patient. Just where they are, thank you so much. Where they are, Benhams, just where they are. Benhams, where the bishops are, thank you very much. So talk to me. About the leg. So, what was the condition of that leg? Why were you on the wheelchair? From the accident. There were glasses from the accident. What was the condition of the leg? How could you use it? Were you able to use it or not? were not able to walk.
Yes.
And is that how, that's how you ended up on the wheelchair?
Pardon?
Is that how you ended up on the wheelchair? This wheelchair.
They took me without the wheelchair from my past.
Okay,
they took me to
just carried you. How did they take you without a wheelchair?
This one. When I was born there, they used to beat and tell me that they want to kill me. To make the ambulance and police, Western people. The police told me to cannot go one corner of the street like that. Then I told police, no, I can't go away. Yes, you can.
Okay. How did you end up on the wheelchair?
Wheelchair, I decided to follow up. My uncle said and told that they cannot take me and stay with me because they don't want to.
Yes.
One servant of God said, make them stop because I know Eldoret more than to just
So you were that's amazing. You were sitting on this wheelchair and begging with this. Without. Sitting on the floor. This leg could not step down, you say?
Without stepping. The servant of God always brought me there. Then police put me to one meeting at the bar. And I was then they were supposed to call this machine by your hand so that they didn't step down.
Yes. And then after that, you still went back to bed.
Yes, I continued coming back. They tried to send me back at home to my father with police. That was his choice as well. Then my father said, I thought this one would be.
So you were sitting at task is begging?
Yes.
Without the wheelchair?
Yes, without the wheelchair. Then I did those tasks. And they even then, one summer of work came out there. Then they gave me each promise to provide my eyes.
So, this wheelchair was given to you last year?
September.
September.
Yes, ma'am.
And you continued sitting with it and begging with those with these documents here from government?
Yes.
Yes. And because you are not able to step down? Because you are not able to step down with that leg?
After being operated that morning, I removed those glasses.
Yes.
So then it came back home. It started
stepping on
toes.
Like this?
Yes.
On toes?
Yes. It was too painful to step down.
Yes.
Because it's marking.
Yes.
It's painful in my body. There's another man here.
Yes.
All of my leg was pain.
Yes. So who brought you here and when did you come?
And there is my brother always said and give me money always from one order. I knew him when I was in the house.
What is his name?
It's Mr. Everton.
So he brought you to this meeting?
Yes.
How did he bring you? Did he push the wheelchair?
We came in this wheelchair.
And then you met people at the gate?
Yes.
Get one?
Yes.
They took your history, they took the video about you?
Yes.
Yes. And after that, what did you tell them about your condition? Both eyes were closed. Totally sealed off, eh? Thank you. That's very good. So now, that was recorded there.
Yes.
Thank you. And then, what happened to you yesterday?
Now, yesterday, I came here with the belief because Mr. Ruben, one of your one of all of them, came and told me, even if I am a beggar, telling that every family can refuse you, but only God can refuse you. I went to my church here in Everett. I was sent out with one pastor. I think it's very
don't mention this again.
Yes, he sent me out then.
He threw you out of the church?
Yes.
Because he said you are a beggar.
He don't want blindness.
and he does not want blindness. And actually, his God does not take beggars, right? There's another God on this side who accepts beggars and cripples, right? Thank you. So he brought you here yesterday. Very well, and sub got very well here. Again, repeat because you are off the microphone. You said you felt like going to refresh yourself in the restroom, yes. But when you touch this way?
Yes, Mama. But then I feel my legs a bit down. Then I don't have any idea like what.
You were. And then you got up and walked.
I had a light stuck in my body.
You had a what?
Light
struck your body.
Yes, so all of my body was full of light. Then my leg was down like this.
It flat the way it is now. Here at night.
Yesterday at night.
Yes, and then?
Then they tried to carry me, but I don't even know how to dance. We dance with the rocket till 6 in the morning.
The beggar. Son Wanyonyi, can you come and help me? Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Wanyonyi. Can you open it up fully? Pole. Who knows these things? Do you? That would be Pastor Silas. And you are still walking until now. Can you open this thing? My legs are still strong. A beggar, crippled. And now the Lord has done this work here. This wheelchair. Utarudi kwa kiti tena. Umekanyaga chini.
Inside.
It is still inside.
Yes, it is
So you are looking at me with this eye, and you see me, but this one not yet. It's coming out, eh?
Yes.
Thank you. The Lord is working a very wonderful work on you now. Now you are stepping down. Begging with this. All the time. Next is the supermarket. He went to one church.
Alienda kwa kanisa moja,
and the pastor threw him out.
Na mchungaji akamtupa nje.
He said no.
Akasema hapana.
We don't take beggars and blind people here.
Hatuchukui watu ambao omba hapa na vipofu na viwete.
He said those are good for nothing.
Akasema hao ni bure tu.
And then
alafu,
now the Lord remembered him.
Sasa Bwana akamkumbuka.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Asante sana.
I saw you jumping, trying to beat it down, whatever, in testing it, right? Testing it. You were testing it. You were jumping to test it, or what? So you were testing how to find out if God is there.
Yes,
a lie. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Give my daughter there a chair. Thank you so much. Thank you. A chair for my daughter here. Thank you. Thank you so much. So now, our God is triumphant.
Mungu wetu ni mshindi.
Major General, come.
Major General, John.
Gitonga. You want to sit? You don't want to sit there, yes. Gitonga, you're going to hold this side. Major General, hold there. Hold the wheels. The Archbishop will help you hold forward.
Hallelujah.
Come with me. Hey, who's your twende? Come with your twende. Follow me now. Just look straight, you'll see me. If you look straight, you'll see me. Straight, you'll see me. Touch me. Okay, follow me then. Follow me. Can you walk in front of me now? That's a Peter upande upande wa left. Enda kabisa mpaka kwa stairs huko chini. Koja. Kuna ngazi mbele. There are stairs in front of you.
Kuna ngazi mbele zako.
Fungueni mapito pale mbele. Simama kwanza. Unaniona, sio? Okay. Ukiangalia hapa kuna hii chuma. Hii sio stairs. Stairs kabisa. Stairs ni upande huu. Upande wangu hapa. Hapa. Right. He has to learn to live with sight. Make sure you don't fall now. There are chuma that will help you to hold. Are you seeing them? Pole pole. Hiyo ni sawa, lakini chuma. Shika chuma. Chuma. Hiyo ni sawa. Hiyo umeshika ni sawa hiyo. Alafu chuma ndio hiyo upande wangu hapa. What do you want to do? See that one? Thank you. Now be careful, there's a step there. Next is a step. The next one. Are you touching this? You can see it. Touch it, touch it. Use it. Use this one also. On this side also. You see that? Pole pole. You just walk forward. Bele, see your left, see your right. Musitembe, mutamconfuse sana, musitembe. Tafadhali kwa jina la Yesu, mama pale ulipo. Tembea tu vile unaweza popote mbele huko kabisa. Worship team, join me. Usiende left ama right, enda tu mbele kabisa. The beggars is running. Look at that. 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 Sasa geuka turudi nyuma. Turudi tena kwa madhabahu. Turudi kwa madhabahu. Unifuate. Fred, can you hold where Major General is holding? Fred Otien. Thank you, Stephen. Thank you very much. Put your two straight, Kabisa. Put your two straight, Kabisa. Major General, don't confuse him. Step out. Put your two straight, Kabisa. Look at that. You can see the stairs. To me, I rail your side to Guza. Support my rail. Guza, you're to my side. Put your two straight, straight, straight. Put your straight. Put your straight. Hapo naenda kwa watu. Fungua macho uone mbele. Somebody will lead you until you get to see very clearly. you are walking. And see. Father, thank you very much in the name of Jesus. Thank you so much for helping this man. Everybody lift up your hands. We receive Jesus. Everywhere in this place. Those at the altar, sit down, because you will block people. I'm glad Rwanda has come back. Huyo mama alipata mtoto. I'm glad Rwanda has come back. Now, on this accord, let us receive Jesus.
Big.
And let us just lift it very, very high. On that cross. On that cross, he was not tired. Look at, Michael is not seeing the people. Look at that. Because he's sitting. I knew that. We need to get some cameraman to help us. You just remove Michael and put somebody else. Look at this multitude going back to Jesus. All the way to the end, lift it high. Thank you very much for choosing Jesus. Nani muwache hiyo mambo ya carpet kando kabisa, sisi tunaokoka. Atujali hata hizo mambo. Hata sio important. Inua mikono juu.
Lift up your hands.
And I want us to repeat like thunder.
Na ningependa turudie kama radi.
Kama umeme.
Kama umeme.
Na radi.
Na radi.
Na ngurumo za mvua.
Na ngurumo za mvua.
Na tetemeko la ardhi.
Na tetemeko la ardhi.
Look at them. They are just broken out into clapping. It's unbelievable. This is it. This is the revival I talked about. So, lift up your hands high and repeat in two languages. Okay, lifting hands up. Repeat very, very loud.
Rudia kwa sauti kubwa kubwa mno.
Say, Mighty Jesus!
Mighty Jesus!
Sema Yesu mkuu!
Yesu mkuu!
I repent tonight. And receive you right now.
And receive you right now.
Nakukupokea sasa hivi.
Nakukupokea sasa hivi.
As my Lord.
As my Lord.
Kama Bwana wangu.
Kama Bwana wangu.
And my Savior. Jesus!
Jesus!
Yesu!
Yesu!
Mighty God!
Mighty God!
Mungu mkuu!
Mungu mkuu!
Wonderful Counselor!
Wonderful Counselor!
Mshauri wa ajabu!
living bread.
A living bread.
Ukate ulio hai.
Ukate ulio hai.
A living stone.
A living stone.
Jiwe lililo hai.
Jiwe lililo hai.
The bright morning star. Receive you now.
I receive you now.
Nakupokea sasa.
Nakupokea sasa.
As my Lord.
As my Lord.
Kama Bwana wangu.
Kama Bwana wangu.
And Savior.
And Savior.
Na Mwokozi.
Na Mwokozi.
Lord.
Lord.
Bwana.
Bwana.
Fill me. With the Holy Spirit.
With the Holy Spirit.
Na Roho Mtakatifu.
Na Roho Mtakatifu.
And holiness.
And holiness.
Na utakatifu.
Na utakatifu.
Precious Jesus.
Precious Jesus.
Yesu wa thamani.
Yesu wa thamani.
Today.
Today.
Leo.
Leo.
I am born again. I know there are many here.
My Lord,
Bwana wangu,
this man here,
huyu mwanaume hapa,
was brought yesterday,
aliletwa jana,
a lunatic,
akiwa mwenda wazimu,
tied with ropes,
akiwa amefungwa na kamba.
Bring the ropes, I see them there.
Leta kamba nizione.
The Lord beautifully touched
him. But today, when you enter this ground, my Lord,
lakini leo ulipoingia uwanjani humu bwana wangu,
they noticed that you suddenly come.
Wakagundua kwamba ghafla binti amekuwa mtulivu.
And he's very calm. The Lord has healed him.
Na ni mtulivu sana, Bwana amemponya.
Archbishop,
Askofu,
this is it now.
Ndio hii sasa.
They know him, right?
Wanamjua.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My Lord,
Bwana wangu,
this man,
huyu mwanaume,
had a very bad chronic skin disease.
Alikuwa na gonjwa sugu mbaya sana la ngozi.
He was recorded at the gate yesterday. Pus and blood oozing.
Alirekodiwa kwenye lango la wagonjwa jana akiwa anatoka usaha.
And blood.
Na damu.
But today, when the Lord brought you here,
lakini leo wakati Bwana alipokuleta hapa,
the wound cleared,
vidonda vilikauka,
and the skin has changed,
na ngozi imebadilika.
Thank you.
Asante.
Now rise up.
Asante. Sasa inuka.
Okay. Don't worry.
Sijari.
These ropes.
Hizi kamba.
Walitumia kukufunga. Ongea na simama vizuri, simama straight. Tengeneza shati. Tumetoka bali na Yesu.
We have come from far with Jesus.
Okay, asante sana, my son. What is your name?
Jina lako nani?
My name is Peter.
Fungua macho. When you're talking to me, always face me and open your eyes. Your name is Peter who? You were born and ulizaliwa kwenye wakati wa kuzaliwa ukaitwa Peter Ndirangu. So when you were born, you were named Peter Ndirangu. So tell me, do you recognize this? Can you speak on the microphone? Your friends did what?
they tied you up. Unaongea Kiswahili ama Kiingereza? Unaongea Kiswahili pia? Kidogo ama? Okay, warafiki wako walitenda nini na hii? Okay, I am going to put my microphone there. Walikufanya vibaya?
How?
Walikufunga? Tell me, are you violent? You're a peaceful man. Thank you very much. Now, but do you remember your condition when you were being brought here? Your thoughts are now becoming very clear. The Lord cleared your thoughts. And you made them now, the minds, okay. So you are not beating people anymore, you are not violent. You just Christ what? You are a Christ people. Can you stand straight now? You stand like police officer, security people. Just stand normally. The Lord has set you free, my son. And then he touched you here a few minutes ago. Cannot withstand the presence of this place. Of this what? You cannot withstand the presence of this messenger. What did you feel when I passed here? When I passed here, what happened? You don't know, but you were down there. The Lord touched you, my son. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. How precious. Now, you are going to serve the Lord. They will help you with new clothes. And then you will just go to church and start evangelizing Jesus. You are a very powerful young man. It is over now. Because I see your medication here. This was your medicine, right? You used to take them, right? About the look of it, the rich look of it. Glucose, pure glucose. Do you recognize this? And this one? Who gave them to you? Start it from there. Okay, thank you so much for that story. You bring it up from there. But now, when the Lord touched you today in this place, how did you know that you have been healed? You found that your mind is clear. You are telling me like that. What else did you feel? You've never come across to me. Amen. powerful, yes. Yes. But you see, the Lord now sent me here. And the people in Naivasha were trying to block me. And then the deaf ears opened there. And the lame walked. But lakini ujumbe yako nilifikisha bado. Sidiyo? Kutoka kwa Bwana. Si amekupenda sana? Ndi rangu. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you so much.
Asante sana.
Utamsaidia sana na nguo mpya.
You will help with the new cloth.
And then he will take the gospel to the streets.
Alafu ataipeleka injili kwenye mitaa.
And the Lord will never put him to shame.
Na Bwana hatawahi kumwaibisha.
The Lord will provide for him.
Bwana atamtualia.
Uganda, I see you.
Uganda ninawaona.
I see Tororo.
Ninaona Tororo.
I see Mbale.
Naona Mbale.
I'm talking about Uganda. I see Tororo. Uganda.
Naona Tororo.
I see Mbale.
Naona Mbale.
Kampala.
Kampala.
Namaingo.
Namaingo.
Jinja.
Jinja.
Iganga.
Iganga.
Nakasero.
Nakasero.
Kololo.
Kololo.
Mkono.
Mkono.
Mitiana.
Mitiana.
Mubende.
Mubende.
Chotera.
Karisizo.
I see Barara.
Naona Barara.
Toro.
Toro.
Everywhere, Masindi.
Kila mahali Masindi.
Sebei, Sebei.
Sebei, Sebei.
Look at what happened in Kapchorwa here
Kasama
today.
Kile kilichotendeka Kapchorwa hapa.
The Lord touched her, right?
Bwana alimguza.
Thank you so much.
Asante sana.
Amazing.
Yashangaza.
In Tanzania, I see you.
Na Tanzania ninawaona.
Rwanda, I see you. Just make Rwanda sure you nawaona. Fight.
Hakikisha unapigana.
Until we meet.
Hadi tukutane.
From whichever country you come from, you fight.
Kutoka nchi yote utokayo, wewe pigana vita.
Until we sit and meet and give a date.
Hadi tuketi na tuongee alafu tupeane ile tarehe.
Because it's like you can see it's too busy.
Kama vile unavyoona imesongamana sana.
Too busy, you can see very busy.
Imesongamana sana.
And I'm fasting also for these people.
So
I'm not available to meet you people. But when we open the fast, fight until we meet. Even Uganda and Tanzania. You can fight the bureaucracy.
There
is some bureaucracy here that must be fought. So this is the situation, eh? What has happened here? My son, what is he able to walk?
Yeah?
He can walk with his feet. Foot. Has he come walking? Can you walk, my son? I see. This miracle, I heard about it yesterday when I arrived. How Jesus put an archbishop.
Yes, my Lord.
Can you just stand here and present this thing to these people?
My Lord,
Pastor Israel, why are you not here? I want the archbishop to take his time and yesterday, the way he presented this, it was so powerful. We could not sleep. Because Jesus is creating new bones.
Yes.
Yes. We are going to hear this. I don't know where the camera is anymore. We don't know which camera we are on. Whether here or here. Is it here? Where is the camera that you're facing? No, that's a little bit on the back. I think there should be a camera on this side. So now my son, come this way. We can step on it and walk with it. Turn a microphone. That is always a very hot place, right? Thank you. Because you translate my words. And I'm not your brother. I'm not your uncle. I did not come from Kenya. I came from the Lord. Hallelujah. That's a hot place, right? Okay. You know that it's sensitive, right? Thank you. So now, This is a big miracle. Talk about it.
My Lord,
Bwana wangu,
4 years ago,
this boy
Isaac was bitten by a snake.
Alikumwa na nyoka.
And the poison caused the leg to rot.
Na ile sumu ikasababisha mguu wake kuoza.
And so the bone was cut and removed.
Basi ule mfupa ukakatwa na hata ukaondolewa.
The bone was cut and removed.
Yes.
From this leg.
From this leg.
The bone was removed.
Mfupa ulikatwa na ukaondolewa.
And then
kisha
the whole leg on that side,
mkuhuna wote katika upande huu,
became numb like it died.
Ukakupa ganzi kana kwamba umekufa.
There was totally no feeling in that leg.
Hakuwa na hisia zozote katika mguu ule.
But yesterday,
lakini jana,
when the young boy came here,
wakati kijana mdogo alipokuja hapa,
using these two crutches,
akitumia mikongojo
meaning miwili, that leg was, the bone was removed.
The bone was removed. The leg was too weak. It cannot support the body.
Thank you so much, Jess. So he doesn't use it for walking.
He doesn't use it for walking.
Mama yake uko wapi? Ama baba yake? Can you come to me? Are you the one who brought him? Do you know him? You brought him? Come then and talk about your brother. After the Archbishop. Let the Archbishop finish. Mama, I'm on Facebook. So, if I understand right, the bone was removed. And there was no bone there.
There was no bone.
So it was weak.
It was weak, only flesh.
Thank you.
And the leg was numb and it died. It could not step down. And the boy could not walk without the two crutches. Because he has no bone. But yesterday, when he came here, following the word that he spoke by Lord already,
can we remind people of those words?
Yes, please, my Lord.
That the meeting in Eldoret has now fallen. Right under the fearful jurisdiction of the mighty anointing of the Lord.
Chini ya utawala wa kuogofya wa upako mkuu wa Bwana.
Has fallen in there.
Imeanguka mle ndani.
And I said,
nani kasema?
Now anything and everything can happen there.
Sasa kitu chochote na chochote kile chaweza tendeka mahali pale.
And I did not want to say even an earthquake can happen there.
Na sikutaka kusema kwamba hata tetemeko la ardhi yaweza tendeka pale.
No.
Hapana.
I just said anything can happen there.
Nilisema tu chochote chaweza tendeka pale.
In terms of healings.
Katika masuala ya uponyaji.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because the same time.
Kwa sababu ulimi ule ule.
I said earthquakes.
Umenena kuhusu tetemeko la ardhi.
And they have happened.
Na imetendeka.
I said in a good way.
Basi nikasema kwa wema.
That anything can happen there.
Ya kwamba chochote chaweza tendeka pale.
In a good way.
Kajia nzuri.
That my daughter may wake up.
Ili kwamba binti wangu aweza kusimama.
And give me a long story there.
Na nipe hadithi ndefu pale.
At one point I say, where are we headed with this story?
Kwa wakati fulani nikasema, jamani tunaelekea wapi na hadithi hii?
It was the building of the testimony.
Kumbe ilikuwa ni kujenga ushuhuda.
Thank you so much.
Asante sana.
Thank you. Look at me in the eye.
Nitazame kwenye macho.
Thank you, my daughter.
Asante.
Thank you very much. So you say now, following those words,
unasema kwamba kuzingatia maneno yale,
following the words of the mighty prophet of the Lord,
kuzingatia maneno ya nabii mkuu zaidi wa Bwana,
that the meeting has fallen.
That the meeting has fallen
under that kind of authority.
Ya kwamba mkutano umeanguka katika mamlaka ya aina hiyo.
So this young man,
basi kijana huyu mdogo,
yesterday after they were recorded at the gate,
jana baada ya kurekodiwa pale kwenye lango,
ulirekodiwa kwa gate,
when he stepped down,
alipokanyaga chini,
he felt a little pain,
alihisi uchungu kidogo,
and then,
na kisha,
he felt that there's life in that leg.
Akahisi kuna uhai kwenye ule mguu.
If you don't shout for Jesus,
ikiwa hautapaza sauti kwa Yesu,
even the mountains will shout for Jesus.
Hata milima ita-
If you don't cry for Jesus, even the oceans will cry for Jesus. If you don't clap for Jesus, the trees, they will clap for Jesus. If you don't dance for Jesus, the stars, they will dance for the Lord. Somehow, somebody will praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, so, the leg that was dead, and soft, no bone.
Hey.
Now had life.
Tasa ina uhai.
Number two,
ya pili,
had strength.
Ina nguvu.
And the boy now,
na uchungu sasa,
was able to walk.
Kijana angeliweza kutembea
without the crutches.
Bila mikongojo.
And the leg,
na miguu,
that has no bone.
Abaya ina mifupa.
Is able to support the body.
Yaweza kusitiri mwili.
As the leg that has no bone.
Miguu isiyo na mifupa.
The archbishop has said that in the leg that had no bone now started supporting the body as though it has a new bone.
Yes.
Jesus is Lord.
Yesu ni Bwana.
Amen and amen.
Amen, amina.
Turudi huko, my son. His one hand is still. Thank you so much. I just want to hear a little bit from you people. And did you get your soda today? Your Fanta? Not yet. You'll be given Fanta. Thank you. So talk to me.
I love
huyu kijana yeye mguu ilikuwa na madeni ongea na mimi kuhusu vile nyoka iliuma mguu.
My brother aliumwa na nyoka na wakati alipelekwa riparo after 3 days wakasema maybe ni tete na kwa sababu alikuwa kanda ya sengenge. But after 1 month mguu ilirudi tu kuvimba ikabidi wafanye operation and then that is the time when he realized kwamba kulikuwa na sumu imeozesha mfupa kutoka kwa magoti kurudi chini. So daktari alipropose ikatwe na mzazi naye akasema wakate, but daktari kutoka Kenyatta akasema hapana, mwache mtoto bado ni mdogo, atatembea mara nyingine na kwa sababu Mungu alimuumba atairejesha mfupa mwingine.
Yes, alafu ile fupa walitoa
ilitolewa,
mguu ikakuwa soft,
ikakuwa tu soft, angetembea bila crutches, hata tukokuwa mbeba tukakaa waje kumjia crutches.
So you know this leg?
Yes.
This leg has been flesh, no bone.
Ilikuwa tu weak, ingeani hata ingakuka wadeza saida angetua tukulake na kona shida.
This is a big miracle has happened here.
Huu ni muujiza mkuu sana ambao umetendeka hapa.
And then,
na kisha,
where did you enter?
Uliingilia wapi?
Uliingilia mlango gate 1.
Na liingilia kwenye lango la kwanza.
Wakati nilimjuna akawa anashtuka, nikamwambia Mungu wewe ni wa ajabu. Baada ya nusu saa akaniambia mimi sioni nitatembea. Sasa saa 12 nina worship na mtoto anaamka anaenda zake.
Ameamka ameenda zake. Na wewe kazi yako ni kumfuata. Na haleluya ya juu sana.
Nilikuwa nina worship sasa baada kumuona nikashtuka sikuamini. Nikabaki penye nilikuwa mpaka
thank you so much.
Asante sana.
So now,
sasa,
what happened to you, my son?
Ni nini kilikutendekea mwanangu?
When you entered here.
Ulipoingia hapa.
Ulisikia uchungu kwa mguu. I felt pain on the leg. Hukuweza kusikia mapema hapo uchungu? Mapema hapo ulikuwa unasikia vipi kabla hujaingia? Kidogo. Ulikuwa unasikia mtu akichuna unasikia kidogo. Ulikuwa unasikia?
Na ulikuwa unaweza kutembea nayo? Niambie, ulikuwa unaweza kanyaga na chini? Vile unatembea hapa. Ulikuwa unatembea kabla hujakuja ama baada ya kukuja hapa? Okay, I think he's mixing two dispensations.
Anachanganya majira mawili.
Dispensations.
Majira mawili.
Nasema, wachana na mambo ya hapa. Wakati ulikuwa nyumbani pale. Nyumbani ni watu. Where is home? Where? Soy. Soy, yeah. Home is soy. And so, tell me about that. Kule soy, mugu walitoa fupa. They removed the bone. And when they removed the bone, what was happening with the leg after that? How were you feeling the leg? I was feeling that the leg was playing around, whatever, meaning falling this, but I want to dig deep on this. Inacheza vipi, niambie. Inaanguka. Can you show, tell me how it was doing?
Nionyeshe jinsi ilivyokuwa ikifanyika.
Inaanguka nje huko, inaanguka wapi, whatever. Sema tusikie. Inaenda what? Inaenda na mwaka? Hivi? Peke yake. Peke yake. It was going, falling this way and so on. So there was no feeling on that leg. You could, hukuwa na kuhisi kwa hiyo, hukuhisi. Ungeweza kuhisi. Kwa maana unasema inaanguka peke yake upande huu. Peke yake. Ulikuwa uwezi kuhisi ama ulikuwa unahisi kwa hiyo mguu? Do you know the meaning of kuhisi? Unajua kuhisi ni nini? Kusikia, si ndio? Inaanguka peke yake. So it was falling on its own. Like which side? Like this, right? Fanya na mkono tuona pale gani. Hata mkono hii pia nataka ifanye. Eh, ufanye hivi. Inaanguka hivi. Ama ilikuwa inaanguka upande huu. Pale gani? Oh, it was falling on this side on its own, eh? No feelings, in other words. Alafu, nini ilitendeka hapa? Jana wakati mulikuja. What happened when you entered here? Nini ilitendeka hapa? Very powerful. But that's when I began to feel pain on this leg. And this leg had been given back its life. And where there was no bone, now there is a bone that's stepping down. I may not know how. I may not know the reason. I may not understand now. I may not be able to explain. But I know one thing. That my Lord Jesus, He knows everything. And He went to the cross and said, "It is finished." Even bones are formed. This is very powerful and beautiful. Sasa muwapatie viti waketi na huyo mama. Thank you, my daughter. Thank you.
My Lord, another. This is very big.
So today we are really in the midst of miracles. I told you, go to Eldoret. Eldoret mambo yake ni mazito.
Eldoret mambo yake ni mazito.
Go and prepare Eldoret.
Enda uandae Eldoret.
Na leo kweli ni mazito.
Ni mazito.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Eldoret.
Eldoret.
Mambo yake ni mazito.
Mambo yake ni mazito.
There are healed people here.
Watu walioponywa wako hapa.
There are people healed here.
Kuna watu hapa ambao wameponywa.
Am I going to leave? No.
Je, nitaenda? Hapana.
I saw a dream.
Niliona ndoto.
And in that's why it's better to work without live coverage.
Ndio maana ni vema hata kufanya kazi bila kupeperushwa moja kwa moja.
Because then you are not rushing the Lord.
Basi hapo haumharakishi Bwana.
And I said it on radio that I will not. I will just ignore it.
Na nikasema kwenye radio ya kwamba sitafanya hivyo.
Because these miracles are not happening anywhere on the earth. So we need to receive them with all our hearts, all our souls, all our mind, all our strength, all our life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I saw a dream. And I was going to the meeting. It puzzled me very much. This meeting. And the Lord said, by voice, look, you are going to the meeting. And you have carried the clothes, the Lord's clothes. Only for the 2 days. But look, you have forgotten to carry for the night. Are we going to have a kesha or what? I began to wonder. I said, but it's not New Year. So even yesterday as I was packing, I was saying, why? I just packed more actually because I said, in case I heard. I packed more. Because I have to obey. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because this is night time. And we are still here. And God is still healing. And you are not happy or happy with it. Who are you? Are you happy with the healing? If you ask the bishops and the pastors here, you will find that they don't see these miracles. Please, let us behold them with honor. Only this matters to Jesus. In Angola, only 3 cripples walked. And yet in other countries, in Trinidad, was there a cripple that walked? That lady who was bedridden for years walked. And then the tumor, the Lord walked in the, he was big also. The Lord walked in the meeting and removed my hand like this, physical, like this, a tumor. And passed it through the ear, so it did like that. But what I'm saying is that these miracles are happening nowhere else. We can delay the going just a little bit. Me, I'm not tired. If you see people like him, the skin that was oozing past, now dried. The drillings on the head, the legs that had no bones, now they have new bones. The daughters that were lying on mattresses, now they got up and they can sit and walk. And the mother is here. And my daughter here.
Say,
why are you wasting time with Naivasha? How come you can't see this thing open?
Even the talking.
Also talking. She's, yeah, she's saying her tongue has, she wants to talk. It's amazing. Well, thank you. Hallelujah. Yesu, yeah. She has been saying something since then. I don't know what she's trying to pass to me. Yes, because you pain or whatever. Big.
Yes, my.
Let us not go home.
Tusiende nyumbani.
The people from abroad.
Watu toka ngambo.
Please, just a few more minutes and we'll finish properly.
Tafadhali dakika kidogo alafu tumalize.
Don't worry. This is revival. People don't go back home.
Musichali, huo ndio uvuvio. Watu hawarudi nyumbani.
Hey! Brazil! I am coming.
Ninakuja.
I have seen the meeting.
Nimeona mkutano huo.
Yes, now we are not live, so I can say things, right? Oh yes, it's better like this. Because live TV puts you in a box. And I've been rebuking that thing. How can I go into it? To box God.
Katika Mungu wa box.
Kuweka Mungu ndani ya ratiba ya binadamu.
Kumweka Mungu katika ratiba ya mwanadamu.
New people have been healed. Look at there.
Watu wapya wameponywa hapa. Tazama hapa sasa.
Worship team. Anybody who is sick in the worship team, HIV AIDS, cancer, closed wounds, kidney, whatever, your healing has now come in the name of Jesus. How do you go home? After all the broadcast in 3 hours, just manage yourself carefully. I rebuked it in Nigeria. How can I then come and call it rich under its jurisdiction? The little babies walked. They stood up. A radio was put on their ears. How can you go home? Thank you so much. This one? Oh, this one. Look at it. How precious. Give him a soda. If you have his very special kid. I wish a pastor can follow him up. Yes, follow him. Sit very well. Sit. Just follow him so we can follow his life and work and be involved. You see that?
Okay?
Who is involved with this kid? What? Who is involved with this kid here? Can you bring the judge that is standing there from the Czech Republic to sit here? The mother. Mama mtoto, jina lake ni nani hata tujui. We don't even know the name of this boy. Bernard. The mother to Bernard, if you're around, come here.
Mamake Bernard, come
over. Wewe ni mamake. Mama, this is your grandchild. When ni jirani yako, when did you ulimleta? Where did you get him from?
Ulimpata wapi?
Where are you people from? Matunda? We need to follow this. What is your contact? Can we get his contact? Somebody can get his contact here? You can get his contact now and help Jesus? Take it now. Take his contact fully so we follow up this kid. So we can love this kid. If that was you, you would have wanted somebody to love you also. Chukua vizuri kabisa number ya simu pia kila kitu. We need to help this boy.
Tunahitaji kumsaidia mtoto huyu.
What has happened here?
My Lord, this is very big.
This
boy came here yesterday and he was recorded with a big tumor.
tumor as a pregnant woman.
Akiwa na uvimbe mkubwa kama mwanamke mjamzito.
Close to this.
Ukakapo kiasi hiki.
Very big with swollen legs.
Ilikuwa kubwa sana na miguu yake ikawa imefura.
And the face of the mother.
Na uso wake ukawa umepinda.
Yes, my Lord.
Ndio Bwana.
Ilikuwa size gani? Yanisha. Oh, that is big. Wait, okay, I'm going to turn the camera there. Thank you. Ilikuwa size gani? That is a big tumor.
Huo ndio uvimbe mkubwa.
Yesterday.
Jana.
But today, when the Lord brought you here,
lakini leo, Bwana alipokuleta hapa,
the swelling disappeared.
Uvimbe ukatoka.
Pastor Helen, please. To make sure we get the right translation. So much, thank you. Both his parents, all his parents, both his parents.
Their bodies used to swim and then they just die all of a sudden. So this sickness started him last year in June. He's been visiting witch doctors, and even if he goes there, he's not been healed. The sickness comes again.
Amekuwa akitembelea hata waganga, na hata akienda kule aponi, akirudi ugonjwa hile narejea tena.
He used to be at Migori Hospital and he was transferred to Kisi. And then in Kisi, he met a sister from Russia. He met a sister called Pamela from Russia and is praying at the altar.
Alikutana na dadake anaitwa Pamela na kule Russia, lakini anahudhuria katika kanisa hili.
Thank you. different hospitals in Migori, in Kisti. In one place they said kidney, in another place they said lungs, and in another place they said the bladder.
Katika hospitali tofauti tofauti, hospitali ya kwanza wakasema kwamba kuna shida ya figo, nyingine wakasema kuna shida ya bladder.
Problems at home until I decided to come with to stay with my friend in Awendo.
Nimekuwa na shida nyingi sana kule nyumbani, nikaamua niende kuishi na rafiki yangu mwingine kule Awendo.
My sister had been helping me and then he connected me to a pastor in Rapogi.
Dada yangu amekuwa akinisaidia, ndiye aliyeniunganisha na mchungaji toka Rapogi.
When you came in here, who brought you?
Ulipoingia hapa.
Nani biroka? Ngamano keli.
Ulipoingia hapa, nani aliyekuleta?
Even when I was coming here, I did not have transport. But that sister in Russia is the one who sent to the pastor of Rapogi money so that I can use for transport.
Hata kuja kwangu hapa sikuwa na nauli. Yule dada kutoka Russia ndiye aliyetuma pesa kwa mchungaji wa Rapogi. Ndio maana nikapata kupata kufika hapa.
When he came here yesterday, he came with so much problems. He had a swollen stomach until he was not able to breathe properly. But when he reached today at noon, he felt tired.
Alipokuja hapa jana, alikuwa na shida ya kupura tumbo. Hata kiasi angeweza kupumua vema. Lakini kufikia saa sita leo, akahisi kuchoka.
He's saying that today, after that tiredness, he started to feel some strength in his body. And then after that, when he checked his stomach, he saw there is nothing in his stomach.
So he saw that the stomach has, the swelling went away.
The swelling has back. Gone away. Problem with the eye, and he's praying that when he's from here, that the Lord may do for him all the things, because there were people waiting to see what has happened to him from this.
So already there's a big miracle here, see you? And then now, the eye, what was the problem with the eye? Okay, yes, so the face is swollen. So that face is going to also come down in the name of Jesus. Thank you so much. This is a very big thing here. And we need to know how he needs fair, what? You know, there are several issues that have come up, right? Fair food also. Have you drunk any soda here? I want to give you a soda. Hata kutoka Kisi upande wa Kisero ama ni wapi?
Kisero.
Sasa wamesikiza kwa TV vile mambo yamekuwa na wewe. Kenya nzima imeshukuru Mungu kwa ajili yako. Nikaenda pale nikaimba wimbo la msalaba. I went there and I worshipped about the cross because of you. I stood before the Lord and just praised him for the cross. Because I saw how the cross has worked in you. Thank you. soda. So, Pastor Helen, are you going to help me to find out how he goes home and food and things like that? You can involve us if you want. I know you should. We should, because we need to know. Because he talks about a lot of problems. Food. So the Lord has healed him. He needs to be fed. Thank you so much. Can you sit somewhere? Thank you, my son. Thank you for coming to worship the Lord. I bless you in the name of Jesus. Thank you so much from Amsterdam. Thank you so much for worshiping with us here. And my daughter there from Sao Paulo worshiped with us. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Now, can we? There's a lot of healings that have happened here.
My Lord. With a shriveled hand.
Akiwa na mkono uliopinda.
It was like this.
Ulikuwa namna hii.
She could not stretch it.
Hangeweza kunyosha.
And she could not open the fingers.
Na hangeweza hata kufungua vidole vyake.
She was also born mute.
Pia alizaliwa bubu.
But today,
lakini leo,
the Lord has healed her.
Bwana amemponya.
And she can now stretch that hand.
Na sasa anaweza kunyosha mkono wake.
Is that a small thing or what?
Che, hiyo ni jambo dogo au?
Can we first get a quick drink? Drink for this, for if there is. Thank you, give it to me. Thank you so much. So, yeah. Can we get another one? Thank you. Can we get another one? Thank you so much. Kunyo kabisa.
kabisa kunywa upate nguvu, utapata nguvu ya Bwana. Kunywa tu. Kunywa baba. Kunywa kabisa, kunywa kabisa. Yes, the Lord is going to help them.
Bwana anaenda kuwasaidia.
Kunywa kabisa. This is now the bride of Christ.
Huyu ndio biarusi wa Kristo sasa.
Yes.
Ndio.
These are the ones that love Jesus.
Hawa ndio wale wanaompenda Yesu.
He listens to them very carefully when they speak.
Anawasikiza kwa umakinifu sana wanapoongea.
This is how they look like.
Hivi ndivyo wanavyofanana.
The perfect bride.
Biarusi mkamilifu.
They may not be in Denmark.
Wenda wasiwe Denmark.
They may not be in Copenhagen.
Wenda wasiwe Copenhagen.
They love Jesus.
Lakini wanampenda Yesu.
Sometimes the ways of the Lord are different.
Wakati mwingine njia za Bwana ni tofauti.
This is now the bride of Christ.
Basi huyu ndio biarusi wa Kristo.
And for this bride, I will fight to the finish.
Na kwa biarusi huyu nitapiga vita hadi mwisho.
Even to the point of losing my life.
Hadi katika hali ya kupoteza uhai wangu.
In another dispensation.
Katika majira mengine.
Says it was here.
Mama anasema ulikuwa mikunjana hapa.
Ilikuwa wapi? Fanya na mkono tuone pale ilikuwa. Fanya na mkono yako. Fanya wewe fanya vile ilikuwa. Fanya vile ilikuwa kabla hajafanya. Fanya tuone. Oh, so you had it here. That's what the Lord used it like this.
Bwana akawaachilia hivyo.
Amazing. Thank you so much. Give them some seats and love them, bless them.
Wapeni viti, wapende na umabariki.
Speak to them.
Waongelesheni.
Comfort them.
Na watulize.
Umetoka wapi? Ani ni wapi? Ni keio wapi? Iten. Na wanana Mungu bila mekumbuka. Asante sana. Keti chini kwa kiti za wafalme. Hizo ndio kiti zako za wafalme. Yes. Yeye bado ongea. Yeye bado ongea.
Bado
ataongea. Ataongea. Anasikia? Sasa ataongea. Ataongea usijali. She's a powerful grandmother, right?
Yes, my Lord.
Yes.
Peter Collins of Kisumu.
Kutoka Kisumu.
In June this year,
mwezi wa sita mwaka huu,
he suffered kidney failure.
Aliteseka gonjwa la figo.
And he was put on dialysis.
Na akaweka katika kusafisha damu.
And the doctors recommended that he be sent to India for transplant of the kidneys.
Madaktari wakasema kwamba aende India ili kwamba badilishiwe lile figo.
But the mother,
lakini mamake,
send a message to the mighty prophet of the Lord.
Akatuma ujumbe kwa nabii mkuu zaidi wa Bwana.
Hakuna kuenda kwa dialysis tena.
And the mighty,
no, even the doctor said don't come back.
Hata madaktari wakasema usirudi.
Your son, go to your son now. This boy here. You say, my mother was barren for 16 years. But I thank the Lord for sending his mightiest prophet to us. Now I am 2 years old.
My name is Blessed Samuel.
Jina langu ni Samuel Mbarikiwa.
Put him down pole pole. Weke chini pole pole. Hallelujah. Thank you, worship team, for joining me. I give you soda. I need to give you butter. What a story. You see, my mother was barren for 16 years. Sending his slave here. Because now I am actually turned to. My daughter, you see? Thank you for bringing them to grow up in this. Every time, bring them, every time. To grow up in the glory. That is the official song we will sing in heaven. And that song, it covers all over, all the languages, all the tongues, all the tribes, all the communities. Everybody can sing hallelujah. Even the Chinese and Koreans. They will just sing it as hallelujah. Because now I have turned to. Is that the Nigerian flag? Oh, that's the Mexican flag. Wow. That, Mexico, come up here. Come up. They brought a big flag. Hallelujah.
Story.
I
love to read it. says, my mother was barren for 16 years. Mi madre no tiene señor cerrada su estómago. Yeah. Con años 16 años. O 16 años. No tiene bebé, no tiene niña, no tiene. Pero cuando señor manda su siervo aquí, ahorita yo tiene 2 años. Hallelujah. I'll try to translate it in Spanish. Who can go home to do what? He said, you have carried 2 for the day. How about the night? Even when I was packing, you know, I had just to carry clothes. I did not know what can happen. Come and tell me about Eldoret. Unasema mambo yake ni mazito haya. You are the presiding bishop here. Look at how there is the biggest visitation in the land. Just one of them. We were running with TV. So, hey, we have 3 minutes. We have 4 minutes. And when this testimony came after we went off air, you almost repent. Tell me about the story of Eldoret. This story. My Lord.
Eldoret
is the land of champions.
Eldoret ndio nchi ya washindi.
But,
lakini,
you have brought to Eldoret the champion of
champions.
Hallelujah!
Shujaa.
Imeisha.
Imeisha.
Hata uendi azimu imeisha. Vipofu wana. I want to take the testimonies until 7 p.m. on radio. That prophecy is about to be fulfilled. You see hungry nations. They are waving big flags like this, eh? That the Lord may see that hunger. Apisako, Tlaxcala, Oaxaca, Monterrey, Tapachula, Puebla, Guerrero, Acapulco, Chimaulacan, Puerto Escondido, también. Monterrey, toda México. All the Mexicans will get this gospel. I am ready. Because I am told that
that the sweetest worship happens at night here. Is there any miracle in the house?
Yes, my Lord. As this lady is a member of my church.
Are you talking about the entire national church or the King's Outreach Nakuru? The main altar.
Nakuru main.
She
joined the Nakuru main altar last year around February. The purpose of her coming to church is because she was a barren woman. She has suffered many things.
Ameteseka kwa mambo mengi.
She even went to witch doctor.
Hata waganga.
And they gave up.
They said,
even if you go to Congo, there's no way you can give birth.
Hakuna vile unaweza pata mtoto.
They also say, the doctors, now the medical doctors,
madaktari wa matibabu sasa,
say that she has something like a stone in the womb.
Wakasema ana kitu kama jiwe ndani ya tumbo
lake. So she can never ever give birth.
Basi hawezi kuzaa kamwe.
But last year,
lakini mwaka uliopita,
Santo, Santo. Blessed a third time. But the Lord will go ahead of you and prepare you. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, keep your baby back. Are we done now?
My Lord,
we are not ending tonight.
Yes.
We cannot. We cannot. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. The Lord bless you. We will not stop. Thank you. Even you, the Lord has something for you.
My Lord,
yes.
We have come to you this morning. This young man had a serious fracture as he was playing football. And he has been on this platform for the last 2 months.
He was playing football when he got a fracture.
Yes, my Lord.
Which, can I ask, which league was that? Allow me. Sometimes you have to ask. Because that's a strong league. Thank you, my son.
So, as the man of God came in at about 10,
is it about 11 or so?
About 11.
Yes.
He realized that now he could step down without the crutches.
Tomorrow the doctors are cutting it out.
And they are protected now with the toes.
Even the toes can move.
Yes.
Tomorrow they will cut it out. Have we come to the end now?
No!
No! No!
How beautiful it is at night here. I was told that the night worship is the most powerful. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How blessed are you, Kenya? We have to thank the county government for also keeping us secure. Yes, we must. We must recognize them. It takes a lot of effort to have it. Is that all now? I just want to glorify Jesus and give him all the glory. All the honor. With the mighty doctors that worked very hard. Madaktari wamefanya kazi kwa kasi. Another one is healed. Have you, this is for healed.
Oh,
this is for healed, yes. So the work is not yet over. What has happened now?
My Lord,
this is historic.
He had a fracture.
Uende Rwanda uambie.
Uende Rwanda ukawambie.
Imelipuka pale.
Imelipuka uko.
Revival kubwa.
Ufufuo mkubwa.
Ulifanya the first effort.
Ulifanya bidii ya kwanza.
Ukanipeleka pale.
And you took me there.
Sasa imejengwa. Sasa ndio unataji kabisa kunialika pale. Unaona vile imelipuka sasa.
Sasa unahitaji kunialika.
Lazima tuongee. Lazima tuongee, my son.
We have to talk.
We must speak. I bless you. We must meet.
My Lord, Bwana wangu. This lady had a thigh broken.
dada alikuwa amevunjika kiuno.
She could not walk without that stick from 2010.
Hangeweza kutembea bila hiyo kijiti tangia mwaka 2010.
But the Lord has now healed her.
Lakini Bwana sasa amemponya.
She cannot walk without that stick.
Anaweza kutembea bila hicho kijiti.
Bwana amekuponya.
The Lord has healed you.